Welcome to St. Francis Xavier Shrine, Old Bohemia, the Mother Church of the Diocese of Wilmington. I'm Marji Matyniak, and I'm president of the Old Bohemia Historical Society, which since 1954 has maintained and done restoration on the shrine. This is where it all started. In 1704, Reverend Thomas Mansell, a Jesuit, landed here. The only thing that was here at that time was a cord building, which we call the old kitchen, was built over. At that time, you could not have a Catholic church, and everything was conducted in this one little building, and it was called the Rectory Chapel. Later, around 1720, they built a Rectory Chapel building here. The one you see today was built in 1825. They tore the old one down and saved all the bricks, which, by the way, were made on the plantation, and saved all that they could, and used it to build the building you see here today. The reason they had to do this was you could not build a Catholic church at that time. The edict was not lifted until the 1780s. At that time, they started to build the church here in 1792 and finished it in 1797. These are the famous English boxwoods at Old Bohemia. They were planted previously to 1898 when the Jesuits were here. The English boxwoods are the outer row that you see. A few years back, they were not looking too good, and we were kind of worried about them. And a very generous benefactor came forward and said that he would do American boxwoods. So the outer row that you see are the English. There's an inner row that are American boxwoods. After we put the American boxwoods in, I guess the old boxwoods got the message and they started to grow. And as you see them today, they're back again. Now let me show you the old rectory. This is the entrance hall of the old rectory chapel built in 1825. We have some vestments here that were saved. They go back to the 1700s. They are copes. Winterthur came out, and we were told that they were all made in France. They are all silk, and all the braiding and all are gold. This desk is of great interest because it was actually made here at Old Bohemia by Reverend Villiger, who was a pastor here. He came in 1856. This is a picture of the rectory building that we are standing in now, as it looked before the fire of the church. You can see it is totally different than it looks now. And there is a second story above the kitchen building that I showed you outside. This is a picture of the way the church outside actually looked before January 1912, when it burned down. This picture shows the church after the fire that occurred on January 1st, New Year's Day in 1912. As you can see, all that was left were the walls. These are some pictures of the front of the rectory, the 1825 building, when Pope and Cruz did a dig in 1956. It shows the foundations and part of the old cellars of the original rectory chapel that was built in early 1700s. We feel, as a result of that dig that Pope did in 1956, that some of these foundations is part of the school that was established here in 1745 by Reverend Poulton. The school only lasted about 10 years, but we don't really know why it ever closed. But they had one student here who was called Jackie, and he went on to become Bishop John Carroll, the first Catholic bishop in the United States. This is a mold for making hosts for Holy Communion. And we feel that was brought here probably by the Jesuits in 1704. It was found buried in the basement in the dirt floor. With it, we also have the cutouts that were used to cut out the different molds. When we were setting up for the tercentenary, we chose a blue willow china for a specific reason. During the Pope and Crew's dig, many shards of pottery and glass were found, and some of them were the blue willow. So we do know that some blue willow was used here at that time. This is the old kitchen building, which I showed you from the outside. When the society took over, this was a dirt floor. There were no bricks. One thing of great interest everybody likes to see is this copper-lined bathtub. It was actually used here in the rectory in the 1880s. There was another story above this room at that time. It was removed in the early 1900s and used in a nearby farm to store grain. And it was returned to Old Bohemia in the 1950s. We also have something here that we definitely know that was here during the early days. It was called a sawbuck table. And the reason it's called a sawbuck table, the top lifts off and you can put your log in the cradle and saw your log. We definitely know it was made here on the plantation. This is a museum room in the rectory. And one of the most interesting things we have here is this partial tabernacle, which was found under the eaves on the third floor. And it's believed to have been the tabernacle used in the chapel prior to 1792. We also have a lot of articles that were donated or brought back to Bohemia that were actually used here. There was only one vocation from Old Bohemia, and this was Reverend Brother James Sullivan. And we have some of the things that belong to him, his picture, and some of his articles. We actually know that he was here. During the dig, they dug up a lot of things, and these are some of the things that were found. And there's an abundance of old keys. And the keys were so big, I don't know how you could use the key back then, but obviously they did. And these are some of the shards of pottery and glass that they found during the dig. This is the rectory parlor, and we know for certain that this was the old organ that was used here at Old Bohemia. We are now in the old sacristy, and this is a picture of Bishop Fitzmaurice, who was very supportive of the society when it was founded. He wanted to save Old Bohemia. We are now entering the church as it looks today. We have a few things that were left after the fire. One of them is the bell that you see here and the Stations of the Cross. They were only able to say 13 of them. One is missing. The prayer cards here on this altar were also from the old church. This is where the fire started on New Year's Day, 1912. At this time, it was in ruins, but Bishop Monahan, who was the bishop at the time, said rebuild. So we really owe Old Bohemia that we have today to Bishop Monahan. Now, the original church that was built here and finished in 1797 stopped right here. There was no bell tower and no vestibule. Father Villiger, who I showed you, built the desk in the entranceway, became pastor in 1856, and he's the one who added the vestibule and the bell tower that we have today. Famous people also came to Old Bohemia. You might have heard of the Kitty Knight House, but Kitty Knight really did exist, and she was a parishioner here. Kitty Knight is also buried alongside the church here. This is the cemetery where all the Jesuits who served here so long ago are buried. There are no markings on any of the graves because, remember, at that time, they were called Mister instead of priests. They were just regular plantation owners because of the edict. They are remembered by the Boxwoods who were planted here sometime before 1898.